Welcome to Smart Academy. We are giving CSR Fiscal Science online classes for you. So we are targeting 2021 June. So in quantum mechanics, I discussed some of the concepts up to now. Today I am going to discuss Dirac notation. So let us start our class with Dirac notation. See here, Dirac notation. See here, the physical state of a system can be represented in quantum mechanics by elements of linear vector space, elements of vector space. See, the physical state of a system in quantum mechanics represented by elements of vector space, that is Hilbert space. See what it means, the state of the system represented by elements of Hilbert space. So we can represent the state of the system with the elements of Hilbert space. So these are called what are the elements we are representing the state of the system is called state vectors. Those are state vectors. So the physical state of the system represented by elements of vector space, that is Hilbert space, so those are state vectors. Those are state vectors. Dirac denoted state vector. Dirac denoted state vector. Dirac denoted state vector psi like this. State vector, this is state vector. So this we can call as state vector. State vector. Next, psi star. This is Bra vector. Bra vector. So here this is ket vector. Complex conjugate of ket vector is nothing but Bra vector. See, you just look here, this is ket vector. See like this. Next, complex conjugate of ket vector is nothing but Bra vector. So here phi comma psi equal to phi psi. So this is bracket vector. So bracket phi psi. So see, we are starting from Dirac denoted state vector with ket vector. So complex conjugate of ket vector is nothing but Bra vector. So we can write the state of this phi psi nothing but in the symbol of bracket. So here this one is Bra, this is ket component. This is Bra, this is ket component. So total bracket. So this is a Dirac notation. So now we are moving properties of kits, bras and brackets. So now our topic is properties of kits, bras, brackets. See the properties of kits, bras and brackets. See first one, every ket has a corresponding bra. Every ket has a corresponding bra. This is the first property. So this is catch, this is drop. So complex conjugate of catch vector is nothing but draw vector. Next, see complex conjugate of this one. See if we move outside A, complex conjugate of A, then draw. So where A is complex number. Where A is complex number. So we can write by using above, A shy, cut off A shy equal to A cut shy. Like that, A shy is for see, this is the difference. In cut vector, A is there itself. So there is no complex conjugate. But here, if it is in bracket, it is in bra. So complex conjugate of A, then bra shy. So we can write, so this is the first property. Every cat has a corresponding bra. This cat vector corresponding bra vector. So this is the relations. Just note down. Next, we are moving one more property. Next, properties of scalar part. Properties of scalar product. Properties of scalar product. Here, complex conjugate of bracket equal to bracket of shy phi. Next, we can write phi shy complex conjugate equal to phi star or vector time shy r comma t dq r. So this is also important. In volume space. Next one, we have one relations, some relations here. Shy of A1, shy 1, A2, shy 2, equal. See here, this is bra, this is ket. In ket vector A1, shy 1 plus A2, shy 2. That is equal to A1. Shy 1 plus A2 shy 2. This is a one relation, first relation. So we have one more relation here. A1 shy 1 plus A2 shy 2 of shy. This is equal to, see A1 shy 1 plus A2 shy 2. This is in bra vector. So we get complex conjugate of shy 1 shy plus A2 star shy 1 shy 2 shy. See, just observe here, this is in ket vector, so we got A1 A2. The A1 A2 is in bra vector, A1 star A2 star we got. Then shy 1 shy, shy 2 shy. The third relation we have A1 shy 1, A1 phi 1 plus A2 phi 2. Next B1 shy 1, B2 shy 2. So the relation about this one, see this is A1 phi 1, A2 phi 2. These two are in bra vector. So we will get A1 star B1, phi 1, shy 1. Next, A1 star B2, I1 psi 2 plus A2 star B1 phi 2 psi 1 plus A2 star B2 phi 2 psi 2. See, this is a this is one more relation, so we have three relations here. So just observe and note down. These are the three relations. So next step. We'll see one more property. After this one, we'll see one more property. So that is now the norm is a real and positive. The norm is real and positive. See, for any state vector that is vector of psi belongs to Hilbert space, any state vector which is belongs to Hilbert space. So norm of the state vector is real and positive. This is one property. If norm of is equal to 0, then the state vector also 0. If the state vector is normalized, it is normalized, then equal to 1, the normal equal to 1. If it is 0, the state vector will be 0. If it is normalized, the bracket of psi equal to 1. This is one property. See, I discussed one more property here. Schwarz inequality. See, that is Schwarz inequality. See, simply I written here the inequality equation here. For any state vector belongs to Hilbert space, so that is psi phi modulus square less than or equal to psi phi phi. So this is the inequality relation, Schwarz inequality relation. If state vectors psi and phi are linearly dependent, we can write the relation like this, modulus square modulus b square. So if those vectors are linearly dependent, we can write like this. This is Schwarz inequality relation. So this is the application of this one. Here psi phi are state vectors, A and B are here state vectors. This is inequality relation. What is the relation? A dot B modulus square less than or equal to modulus A square modulus B vector square. So one more is the triangular inequality. One more is triangular inequality. So one more is triangular inequality. Triangular inequality. So this one, so I am showing here only direct relation phi psi phi. Next psi plus phi under root equal to less than or equal to psi phi plus phi bracket. See, this is the inequality, triangular inequality. This is the relation where phi and chi are state vectors belongs to Hilbert space. Those are linearly dependent. This is triangular inequality. In Euclidean space, so the relation will be like this: A plus B less than or equal to modulus A plus modulus B. This is in Euclidean space. This is in Hilbert space. This is triangular inequality. Less than or equal to A plus B modulus, less than or equal to modulus A plus modulus B. Next, are the normal states. One more property, are the normal states. We discuss now are the normal states. Are the normal states? Two vectors, these two are state vectors, are said to be orthonormal. When these two state vectors are the normal, if they are orthogonal, first condition is orthogonal. If they are orthogonal, second one, each one of them has a unit form. Each one of them has a unit form. When these two conditions okay, then those states are the normal states. That means phi equal to 0, bracket of phi equal to 0, then is equal to 1, then phi equal to 1, bracket of phi equal to. But this is the orthonormal states. If these are orthonormal, so they are orthogonal and each one of them has a unit form. This is one condition. Second condition, finally, this is the orthonormal states. So next one, forbidden states. So one more property, forbidden states. So all are not acceptable always, so some of the states are forbidden. So what are the states are forbidden? Now you see, if phi and psi and phi belong to vector space, that is Hilbert space, so product of ket of psi and bra of phi and bra of phi, these states are forbidden states. So we cannot calculate these states. So the application of ket of psi and bra of psi, product of these two forbidden, this is also forbidden states. These are forbidden states. So that means these are nonsensical. There is no meaning for these states. So these are the properties up to now I discussed in quantum mechanics. Thank you. For more videos in quantum mechanics, please subscribe my channel. Thank you.